basketball players that would have some potential in the defensive backfield in football. He's one of them.
He's shaking it off. John Thompson looked him over to see if he wanted to stay in the ball game, and he seems to be all right.
See John Thompson talking to his club now. He does not want to use that timeout. Dean Smith has quite a few left.
Now in this ball game, Doherty has hit 2 of 2 from the line with 4 points. The only guy that hasn't shot perfectly from the line in the starting five is Worthy. He's 2 of 5. This is in the second half I'm talking about. And at the line, Matt Doherty. He hit some big free throws, you might remember, in tournament play in the East region. Now with a big 1-1.
Long. That wasn't even close.
And now Georgetown can take the lead. 1:16 left. That's 10 rebounds for Pat Ewing. Eric Smith off to Pat Ewing.
Hancock was wide open under the basket. Nobody saw him. I figure Sleepy Floyd's going to go for the jumper.
Is he ever? Faked beautifully. Once, twice. Gets a roll. And the Hoyas lead by one. What a play by Sleepy Floyd.
52 seconds.
18 points in the game for the All-American. And as we suspected, it's going right down to the wire.
And Georgetown's going to go into the zone. They are not going to come out and chase. And North Carolina now cannot go to the four corners.
With that odd point, we're going for a game-winning or a losing shot. And Dean Smith asks and gets timeout. That was the 15th lead change we've had in this ball game on that remarkable suspension in midair by Sleepy Floyd. We'll be back. You see the time remaining, 32 seconds to win the championship. Georgetown adds the lead, and I just cannot believe this play that Sleepy Floyd made.
Well, you knew he was going to take it. He's a money player, a double fake. Had a guy in front, a guy behind, and Georgetown getting some nice bounces now. Ewing did the same thing right before that. What it does, Gary, it changes the offensive philosophy completely for North Carolina. They, with the lead, could force Georgetown to be man-to-man. Now Georgetown back in the zone. Most coaches, though, with a timeout, go ahead and change their defense just to throw the other team off stride. Let's see if Georgetown now comes out man-to-man.
Georgetown still has one timeout left. North Carolina has 4. 32 seconds to go. A one-point lead for Georgetown.
No, they stay in the 1-3-1 with Ewing in the middle. They've got to look to get it in there. You can't with a shot blocker like Ewing take so much time.
Doherty to Black. The time, 18. Shot, Jordan, Michael Jordan.
14 seconds.
Brown.
Look for Sleepy Floyd.
Oh, he threw it to the wrong man. He threw it to Worthy.
It's over. It's over.
He's fouled by Eric Smith. Fred Brown, somehow or another, threw the ball into the hands of James Worthy.
Look at Dean Smith, totally in control. Everybody going crazy. See if he doesn't call a timeout to settle things down.
The emotion. Jordan is down. He is down and now getting up. There's
Black.
That's Black. He can't believe it. He's been on 3 straight ACC championship teams, but never won at all. But I tell you, the guy you got to feel bad for is Fred Brown. It's like he looked back. I don't know why or what happened. Let's look at it.
Here it is right here. You know what might have flashed in front of him right there? He saw the blue and the white go by and just lost concentration. That was a smart foul right there. We've got 2 seconds to go.
Look at this. The emotion of NCAA basketball.
Now, Worthy just has to get that ball up there. If he hits the rim, he's in good shape, even if he misses the shot, because Georgetown in bad shape foul-wise.
They had one timeout left.
Eric Smith is fouled out of the ball game.
And after all of that, he did. As he tried to come back and double up and come up with the ball.
Dean Smith looked at James Worthy and said, make these. What else?
Smith leaves the game with 14 points, 3 rebounds. Now, Worthy is the man that I guess should be resting on his shoulders. He's had 28 points tonight, but he's hit only 2 of 5 from the free throw line.
It's a very, very big shot.
Now they're going to call timeout. Is Georgetown calling that?
No, I can't believe John Thompson would have called that. I believe Dean Smith did, just to reorganize the whole situation. He called his fifth. Very surprising, unless John wants to just give him a talk to him about the future, because now he can't do anything other than throw the long pass if the shot is missed.
Well, he's run out of timeouts.
That's right. That's his fifth.
And so even if they get the rebound on this 2 seconds, there's nothing left you can do.
That's right. Very interestingly, in the rule changes in basketball and thinking ahead into next year, although this game certainly is not over. One change we're going to see, the jump ball situation. If the defense creates the jump ball, the ball will turn over to the defense and disregard the pointing of the arrow, which I think most coaches have asked for. The clock, we won't see that at all. And what we may also see, there's been some talk, if a game goes into overtime and a player is fouled out, he gets an opportunity to come back with one more foul.
Well, for so many years, they said about Dean Smith, he couldn't win the big one. He's 2 seconds away from winning the big one now. The seventh time he's been to the Final Four, the fourth time in the championship game. And let's watch. We'll just watch and see what develops.
They call it a two-shot intentional, evidently.
No one moved anyway. That's what it was.
They called it a two-shot intentional. We never did get that signal.
Now there's where they could have used the timeout. And Georgetown loses it. North Carolina has won the 1982 NCAA championship.